So to become a successful forex trader, you need to understand what drives the market. And in order to understand that, you need to first know fundamental analysis. So that you can also understand what the analysts are talking about. So by the end of this video, if you watch all the way to the end, you'll have a basic understanding of what fundamental analysis is all about and how does it work. Alright, so first thing first, what is fundamental analysis? When you're doing fundamental analysis, what you're looking at is you're evaluating or analyzing the economic, political, and social factors that's going to affect the movement in a currency market. So aside from these three factors, it's also affected by natural disasters and wars. And what really drives the market in the long term is the economic fundamentals. And what drives market in the short terms are the emotions of the market, the fear, the greed, and then the herd behavior that drives the short-term movement. Whereas the long-term movement, it is driven by economic fundamentals. And the price movement determined by the currency's supply and demand in relation to the counter currency. So if all else remains constant, the increase in the demand of the currency would lead to an increase in the value of the currency. That doesn't mean that if you see an increase in the demand in that particular currency, that currency is going to for sure increase. You need to compare the demand for this currency as compared to the counter currency. So that's what I mean by in relation. It's all about how your base currency measures up to your counter currency. So when it comes to fundamental analysis, it's mostly used by professional traders and hedge fund managers to trade long term. Whether you do swing trading, position trading, the pro traders use up to 80 to 90% of fundamental analysis and only 10% technical analysis. Whereas you see a lot of retail traders, most of them, they rely mostly on technical analysis and only use a little bit of fundamental analysis. I'm going to elaborate more on what's the difference between pro traders and retail traders in the next few videos. So as long as you're still subscribed, you'll get those tips. Alright, so when you're doing fundamental analysis, you need to ask a couple of questions. So every time when you analyze, let's say, an economic event, you need to ask four main questions, okay? So first question you ask is, what is the political and economic situation of this country based on this data? Not only for this country, but also for the country of the counter currency that you're trading. Based on that comparison, you need to determine which country's economy is growing or slowing down. Let's say today you are trading dollar yen. Assuming that today, let's put things easy, okay? Japan's economy is constant, but then the United States, it is growing. So what do you think would happen to the currency? It would appreciate. On the other hand, you are trading dollar yen, assuming United States economy remains constant. If Japan economy is growing, where do you think the whole entire currency will go? It would, in overall, depreciate. So what if today you're trading dollar yen, but then both countries are growing? United States is growing and then yen is growing. Doesn't mean that this currency will stay stagnant. If the growth of United States is faster than the growth of Japan, in overall, net-net, the currency would, where do you think it will go? It would appreciate. On the other hand, the growth of Japan is faster, then the whole entire currency will in overall depreciate. And right after you determine the growth, you need to determine whether this growth is sustainable or not. How sustainable is this slow growth? How sustainable is this fast growth? Because some economic growth can last for a very long time and some for a very short amount of time. So you need to determine the sustainability too. And as a result of what happened to the economy, you need to ask yourself another question, which is, what would the central banks and government do to manage the economies? So probably they would change the interest rate so as to stabilize the whole entire economy. You need to determine that too. So I'm going to talk more about that later on, or in the next few videos, where I'll talk more about central banks and intervention. And what are the things that central banks do that you need to take note of? That's very important. So how do you use fundamental analysis? So when it comes to interpreting the data, we don't just look at the numbers alone and just draw a conclusion from that. When you read all the reports, you need to read in between the lines to determine what's the meaning behind what that sentence means. Because if it's so easy to just look at a number and then trade based on that, everybody will do it. So in order to interpret what the numbers really mean, you need to have a deep understanding of fundamental analysis. But to put it simply, if you have the conclusion that this particular country's economic outlook is positive, provided that other things remain constant, then the currency will strengthen. And then if the economy is bad, then of course the currency will depreciate and weaken. And when it comes to interpreting data, it's all about comparing expected results and actual results. Because if you see a number that's really, really high, it really doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean that if the value is high, it means that it is good for the currency. So that's why we don't just look at the numbers alone. We need to compare it with actual data. We need to compare it. How is this in relation to a counter currency? So remember, if you go back to the basics, whichever currency on the left side is your base currency, whichever on the right side is your counter currency. So when you're trading a currency pair, you need to take note of these two countries and how are they related to each other and how one's actions affect another. So this is something that my finance professor taught me in school, which is you need to compare consensus with actual data to determine the impact on markets. But then again, doesn't mean that we compare actual then consensus, then that's it. You need to compare it with other fundamental factors too, because what drives the currency market is many, many different factors all under one umbrella, but what you're looking at is only just one of those factors. That's why a lot of people find fundamental analysis really complicated. You compare so many things, you need to evaluate so many things. But it's okay as a start if you're a beginner. I'm going to take you step by step, okay? So don't worry about that. So fundamental analysis, very important not to use it to predict the market. Not even a pro trader can predict the market. Again, we trade in terms of probability. So fundamental analysis is more to use to determine the future conditions of the economy in the long term, in the big picture. And again, we don't use fundamental analysis to scalp, to trade during major spike. Now here's the thing, a lot of people ask, is it okay if I scalp NFP? You compare the difference between retail traders and pro traders. Retail traders, they're going to scalp all the major events and they're going to get stopped out a lot of times. Pro traders, they evaluate what the NFP number means and then they trade for the long term. Three main problems when you scalp NFP. Number one, your cost of trading is going to increase massively. Second thing, nobody knows where the price would go in this minute, in this second. So it's very likely the price is going to hit your stop loss many, many times if you open many, many trades before it reaches your TP target. Third thing is, I don't care whatever system you use. I don't care how perfect your system is during normal times. During NFP time, your system will not apply. It will not work during NFP times. Why scalp NFP and expose yourself to a trading environment where your system doesn't work anymore when you can trade during safer times, when you can trade during normal times where it's less risky? Just because you want fast profit, that's why you trade NFP. The more you chase fast profit, the more the market is going to give you the opposite. So there are many, many downsides of fundamental analysis. And one of them is that you cannot use it to enter and exit. It wouldn't give you an exact price for you to enter. It wouldn't give you an exact price for you to exit. So this is where technical analysis comes in to help you determine exactly which price to enter and then which price to exit. Now, of course, if you heard of the market efficiency theory, sometimes economic events may already have been priced in 6 months in advance. And sometimes months in advance, sometimes 2 weeks in advance. So the market doesn't wait for the number to come out for it to react. So what it does is that it's going to be gradually priced in. So by the time the numbers is announced, most of the time it will be already too late to enter. So what do I mean by pricing in? It's a very common term in finance too. So pricing in means that the events that you see that's going to happen is already reflected in the price. Meaning that by the time you see the price, it has already made its move, in other words. Now, of course, when you combine fundamental analysis and you analyze so many different factors, so many different countries, and then read all the reports, analyze all the data, it's very easy for beginners actually to get into analysis paralysis. And combine that with technicals is going to confuse a lot of people. So you need to strike a balance between having just enough information but not having so much information that you can't even execute the price. And by the time you execute the price, you open a buy and sell, it's already too late. So there are different factors that drive the forex markets, okay? And if I'm to categorize it into 5 main groups, the first one is economic factors, second one is political factors, third one, natural disasters and wars, which is not predictable, fourth one, central bank intervention. So I'm going to talk more about central bank intervention in the next few videos. What does the central bank do that you need to take note of? And of course, market sentiment, which is the feelings of the market. feeling optimistic or pessimistic. So you can use many different markets, many different indicators as a gauge as to what the market sentiment is right now. So I'll elaborate more on that in the next few videos too. And some of the major economic factors that you take note of, some of the ones which has the highest influence. And again, very important not to go jump into trade the NFP, scalp the NFP in the short term, because a lot of bigger traders get killed by scalping NFP. And aside from that, you need to take note of interest rate changes, the FOMC meetings, and also inflation rates by looking at consumer prices. You need to look at retail sales data, housing data, trade balance data, ISM PMI reports, business and consumer confidence, and GDP rates. So GDP rates in the past few decades, it used to be one of the most influential data, but then in recent years, because of economic changes, it has less and less influence to the currency markets. It doesn't mean that right now, or because NFP interest rate has the highest amount of impact, then forever it's going to be like that. It's going to change based on the current economic circumstances. So that's why it's very important for you to adapt your strategy to the changing economic environment so that you don't stay stagnant as a trader. The whole new source for economic news and data, one of the ways is to use the mainstream news agencies. A lot of pro traders, they use Bloomberg platform, which is going to cost you about 1,000, at least 1,000 per month. And then another source, Reuters, MarketWatch.com. So personally, because I come from the finance industry, I was trained how to use Bloomberg before I even learned to use MetaTrader 4 properly. So use this for stock investing analysis. So if you're a stock investor, using a Bloomberg platform will also help you tremendously, but it's not compulsory, alright? So if you don't have a Bloomberg terminal, it's good for beginner traders to start with MT4 because platform is straightforward, a lot of beginners can learn to use it. As for Bloomberg terminal, it takes a lot more time to master. So if you choose not to have the Bloomberg terminal, Bloomberg still offers you a couple of free resources, one of which is the economic calendar that you can use to analyze which are the major data release that's coming up. Whether it's this week, next month. So when you read the economic news, it's very important to understand that a lot of what has been reported already in the newspaper and magazines, in the websites, has already been priced in very likely. Meaning that the market has already adjusted the prices by the time you have received the news. So that's why we shouldn't just trade based on one news alone. So another source that you can get economic data is through blogs, and one of which is Forex Factory, where you can get a very good economic calendar. Now when it comes to economic calendar, you can also find it if your broker offers it. So you check with your broker. But again, not all economic calendars are accurate. So to be safe, you can start with Forex Factory. And also, check your broker if they offer you economic calendars, free resources, free research. And of course, Twitter is also a good source if you follow the right kind of people, the right kind of source. And when it comes to analyst forecasts, it's very important to be aware of this, okay? A lot of times, analyst forecasts, they are not as accurate as you thought it would be. Now, one reason is because a lot of analysts, they have a conflict of interest. Some of them, they are paid to give you a certain recommendation, a stock recommendation, a currency recommendation. Sometimes when they tell you to buy, what they are not telling you is they are buying this asset, but they are behind the scenes hedging other types of assets, which they never tell you. The only thing they tell you is to buy this asset. So there are a lot of conflict of interest when it comes to analyst recommendation. So I wouldn't recommend you just follow it blindly. So analyst forecast, treat it as what the market is currently thinking right now, meaning the market sentiment rather than a mere trading recommendation. Because forecasts are very current circumstances centric. It's very focused on the current moment, on what the market is thinking right now, rather than what's going to happen 1 month later, 1 year later. So if you want to check out Forex Factory, so you need to go to this tab, calendar tab, okay? And then a couple of things that you'll see. The left side here, you'll see this calendar, alright, where you can pick the dates that you're going to see. And this is very useful for you to backtest too, because to backtest, you also need to rely on previous data for you to backtest accurately to determine how come the price moved this way at this date. So if you come to this area over here, you'll see a couple of things. But one thing to take note of is this column called impact, okay? You'll see a different type of color code. Number one is yellow, orange, red. So a lot of traders, what they'll do is that they'll just go ahead and focus on the high impact events. And another column to take note of is this column over here, the currency column. So let's say if you are trading dollar yen today, then you need to make sure that none of the dollar signs here has a high impact event. If there is, then you take note of it. So let's say if today is May 7th, you're trading an Aussie pair. Then you need to take note, at 9:30 p.m., there's a high impact event, retail sales data release. But then again, doesn't mean that you only need to focus on high impact events. Because if the actual data that's released is way too far away from the forecasted consensus, then there might be also a very large movement from the market, a large spike. So if you want to play really safe, focus on all of the important events. So when it comes to individual events such as retail sales data, trade balance, I'm going to elaborate more on it one by one in detail in the next few videos. So as long as you are still subscribed, then you won't miss out on any tips. Alright, so let me know in the comment section down below, how has fundamental analysis helped you in your trading? So with that, I'm careful and I'll talk to you in the next episode. Bye.